So I want to give you a word today that you who have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you've been transferred. You've been moved from the realm of the flesh into the realm of the Spirit. And Paul says, if you walk by the Spirit, you will not carry out the desires of the flesh and the deeds of the flesh. We've been transferred. So we focus in on, as Paul said, I live as Christ. For me to live is Christ. So everything we do is based on Christ. Everything we think is based on Christ. Everything we are is based on Christ. We've been transferred. He also said you've already moved from death to life. So we don't go through. So we live in the realm of the Spirit. Now I know that sounds woo-woo. And you start thinking, everybody saying woo-woo. And it's because we're so connected to our flesh here in the West. Yeah, we are.
Yeah.
We're so connected to our flesh. And we need to disconnect.
Yes.
We need to die to that flesh. Die to self. Go home and kill something. We all have things that we have to kill in ourselves. Amen? We all do. So, go home and kill something. So, I have a word for this year that came out of Titus chapter 2. Everybody know who Titus was? Titus was... Titus was the other Timothy. So Paul spent most of his time, besides planting churches, he duplicated himself into young men. That's a good word for David Graham. I mean, I've seen that call in my life. I was telling Jeremy Grogan yesterday, or Saturday. I received that call in my life since I hit about 40 years old. Duplicate myself into the lives of young men. And so Titus was the other Timothy. All right? So let me grab my Bible.
That he shared with us for the year, for 2015.
love the way it says this. It teaches us to say no to godless ways. I like that. Everybody say no.
Church, and at the very same She lived, and I promised. I told him how what a wonderful prayer we were, and I promised that we would all pray. Can we all pray?
Yes. 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 Amen. Let's do it right now.
Oh, Gary's
here. Let's do it right now.
Yeah.
Amen.
So, Lord, thank you for bringing Gary and Susan back to work.
Please be keeping her prayer.
Amen.
bringing me to Isaiah chapter 43 about the last month, and he brought it again to me this morning. He brought it to me the very first day of 2015, so I really believe that this chapter is going to be a reflection on what he has for this year. But I'm going to pray this chapter over all those. I want to include Rena in there, and I want to include Kathy's friend who's in surgery right now. What's her name? Jennifer. So I want to put that in, and anyone else that is going through a trial or a struggle right now or going through some health issues or anything like that, this is for you. So we're just going to pray this over you. Listen to the one who created you, the one who formed you. He says, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. When you walk through the fire of oppression, you will not be burned up. The flames will not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One, your Savior. I have given you your enemies as a ransom for your freedom. Because you are precious to me, you are honored, and I love you. Do not be afraid. I am with you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. God says, you've been chosen to know me. Believe in me and understand that I alone God. There is no other. There never has been, and there never will be. I, yes, I am the Lord, and there is no other Savior. First I predicted your rescue, and then I saved you and proclaimed it to the world. No foreign God has ever done this. You are witnesses that I am the only God, says the Lord, from eternity to eternity. I am God. No one can snatch anyone out of my hand. No one can undo what I have done. So I believe that this is a scripture specifically over this year. And I find it really crazy what he says here, because I'm gonna, in verse 14, he starts talking to them, Israel, about what he had done. And they were full of fear because the Babylonians were rising up against them. This is what the Lord says, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sakes, I will send an army against Babylon, forcing the Babylonians to flee in those ships they're so proud of. I am the Lord, your Holy One. So he's causing your enemies to flee. So I just speak that right now. Cancer is an enemy, and we declare it to flee right now in the name of Jesus Christ off of Jennifer's body and get out of her brain and every part of her cell of her body. And we just declare that all enemies that stand against these precious ones, these children of God, that you get off right now and you flee in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare that the Lord is rising up armies against you, fighting for his children. I am the Lord, your Holy One, Israel's Creator and King. I am the Lord who opened a way through the waters, making a dry path through the sea. We had a really cool picture of what testimony is last Sunday. We were listening to Eric Johnson preach, and he said, testimony always, always produces, always comes through, always produces fruit, always produces a harvest. Testimony never fails. And he was referring that to an encounter that a couple spies had with a prostitute named Rahab. And in that encounter, Rahab basically confesses her belief in the one true God. And then she goes on to say, we've heard about you. And we've heard about what God did when he parted the waters. And we're trembling in fear. Our hearts are melted with fear. You guys, that was a 40-year-old testimony. 40-year-old testimony that was still producing fruit and harvest. Here we are reading it again. This is hundreds of years later now that God is telling this testimony once again, that I opened a way through the waters, making a dry path through the sea. I called forth the mighty army of Egypt and its chariots and horses. I drew them beneath the waves and they drowned. Their lives snuffed out like a smoldering candlestick. So here's the word for 2015. But forget all that. I read that this morning and I'm like, okay. Forget all that. Verse 18 says, it is nothing compared to what I'm going to do. For I'm about to do something new.
Yes.
See, I have already begun. Do you see it? I will make a pathway through the wilderness. I will create rivers in dry wasteland. Now we know that part of the thing that he was referring to was Jesus Christ. That was pointed to Jesus. An absolute greater thing. A more magnanimous, more magnificent, more glorious thing than the parting of the Red Sea, which caused nations to fear and tremble the one true God. But God is doing a new thing in you. The reality of Jesus Christ in you keeps the testimony of Jesus Christ fresh all the time. All the time, because it's about your experiences with him. It's about your encounters with him. It's about your answered prayers, your victories, your power, your healing. That carries a much greater testimony, because we're not just testifying to an event. We're testifying about a relationship. We're testifying about God encountering his people. We're testifying about God, the God of the universe, adopting us and calling us his own. Knowing you by name, choosing you, protecting you, showing you, revealing himself to you. That is more than a testimony. It creates millions upon millions of testimonies through each individual life. Your encounters with God testify to the world that he is real. Says, you are my witnesses that I am the one true God. You are God's witness. Your testimony shows the world that there is one God. And first of all, we are not him. And secondly, he is worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be lived for. And he's everything that we need and everything we want and desire. Everything. Apart from him, we have nothing. But with him, we have everything. It's both sides of the coin. We have major, major dichotomies here that are completely opposite world. Without God, we are nothing. We have nothing. We can produce nothing. We can do nothing. But with him, there's no limit to the possibilities. 2015 has no limits to the possibilities of what God wants to do in your life. Because with him, all things are possible. I'm about to do a greater thing, he says. I'm about to do a greater thing. So we just want to declare against every enemy that sets itself up against us to ruin our relationships, to tear down our trust or our belief, to bring any kind of doubt or fear into our path. We just declare right now that greater is he who is in us, and that we get to overcome. we win, that we are born. It's our birthright to be victorious now. Because God does not lose. God does not lose.
He has blessed me.
I declare. This is my declaration.
This is my declaration.
So we practice gratitude and praise today that we will tear down every stronghold of the enemy, because we're going to attack every circumstance with praise and gratitude and thanksgiving. For everything that God is, for everything that God has done, for everything we are, for everything He says we can do, and for the fact that God's Spirit is alive and active in us, affecting every moment of our life. So God, we just practice Your presence today, and we just thank You, Father, for new life, the breath of life today, for lungs that work, that are cleared from any mucus or any infection in the name of Jesus. We thank You, Lord, for muscles and strength and power. Sister, I feel, girls, can we gather around this young lady? What's your name?
Ashley.
Can we gather around Ashley? I really feel that we need to pray for you. I don't know what you're battling health-wise right now, but I saw you kind of limpy, so. Okay, so we're right now going to say that every muscle and every bone in your body is knit back together in perfect condition. And so we just speak right now over Ashley's body right now for all tissue damage to be healed in the name of Jesus. I pray for every discomfort and every pain that let her know, oh yeah, I was hit by a truck. And so for all those things to go away right now, we thank You, Lord, for saving her life. We thank You for the angels that You set charge over her. We thank You, Father, that You rescued her and that You have a purpose through this trial to bring glory to Your name. And we just declare right now that Ashley's body comes into alignment with the Word of God that says that she is perfectly made healed and whole by the blood of Jesus Christ. He bore every pain in our body, every sorrow, every grief. And so I just pray right now for every pain to leave Ashley's body in the name of Jesus Christ. And we speak that everything that was hurting is now healed right now. We pray for any bone damage, anything that might have caused bone bruising. I know that that happens, and so I just pray for any bone bruising to be healed right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray for every tissue damage, everything that would cause bruising or blood clots or anything else in her body to be healed completely. And we just call this body to make a complete restoration in the name of Jesus. Anybody else that feels led to pray, please pray. Be filled to overflow. Be invigorated. Be restored. be refreshed, be renewed, be healed.
Amen.
This is the place of health to your body. You shall experience my body becoming yours. I'm going to read that again. You shall experience my body becoming yours. My word shall heal you in this place. My word shall be your health in this place. I rule over your body with my own.
Hallelujah.
My fullness is healing you. My energy is your stamina. If you're tired, raise your hand. If you're experiencing weariness and being tired, okay, this is for you right now. I rule you over your body with my own. My fullness is healing you. My energy is your stamina. My zeal is your passion, says the Lord of hosts. You are restored to first love. You are a worshiper. Enter your place of thanksgiving, rejoicing, and praise. We just declared that that's what we're doing today, right? We just declared that we're entering into rejoicing and praise and thanksgiving. Become invigorated in worship.
Hallelujah.
I am giving you mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual restoration through the power of rejoicing.
Amen.
The joy of your God is your strength.
Hallelujah.
Encounter my majesty.
Amen.
The water level is rising.
Amen.
The water level is rising.
Amen.
The water level is rising. The water level is rising. The water level is rising. Receive your upgrade. Receive your increase. Receive your upgrade. Receive your increase and abide in both. Be renewed and be refreshed. This is key. Stay here until I am satisfied with your renewal and fullness. Let me tell you that today, nothing is more important than you being the presence of God. Nothing. Jesus is the only thing on your list today. Jesus said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And the second commandment is love your neighbor as yourself. So your only job today is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. I understand that you'll go to a job and you'll go and perform a work and you'll do it with a great attitude, with wonderful rejoicing, but you are created to love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength today. That's the only thing on your list. And he says, when you do that, when you seek first the kingdom, everything else will be added unto you. Everything else will be taken care of. Every detail that you think you need to worry about, taken care of when you just love the Lord. Everything that you need, every relationship that needs fixed, taken care of when you just love the Lord with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your mind, with all of your strength. Amen.
So there are those of us, and I'm going to include us in here, who struggle with loving the Lord, our God, with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, because we have complaints against him. We have grievances that we feel are valid because of the pain that we've suffered in our life and the loss that we've had in our life. And we have been blaming God for that. And he is not the perpetrator of any horrible thing that you've ever experienced.
You guys in this world.
Jesus Christ is your hero and your savior. The enemy is the devil.
Yes.
And he has come to rob you, to kill, to steal, and destroy.
Yes.
So this message has to get out because there are saved people who are not healed. And there are unsaved people who can't come to Jesus because they're blaming the wrong source for their pain.
Yes.
The next Triumph Over Trauma is in Riddle. February 6, 7, and 8. This is the only one that's going to be in this area in 4 months. Okay? So there won't be another one until midsummer, probably, in this area. Unless the Lord does something else. But right now, this is the only one that's going to be in this area. So we need to pack the house. We need to get everybody there that can be there. We need to make plans in advance. This is only like 6 weeks away. away, 5 weeks away, for this triumph class. Cost us $35 and a lot of time. Friday night, Saturday day, and Sunday afternoon. Okay?
You lead us by still waters.
crown you as king over our day-to-day time. Be glorified through every action, every word, every attitude that we have today. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Be blessed.
No, it wasn't.
It wasn't, huh?
No. Let me turn this off here.